Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we are going to discuss in our today's video is input and output values of a function. In our previous video, we discussed what is evaluation of a function. And in this video, we are going to see evaluation of functions in different forms. When we know an input and want to determine the corresponding output for a function, we evaluate the function. Evaluating will always produce one result because each input value of a function corresponds to exactly one output value. So when we know an output value and we want to determine the input values that would produce that output value, we set the output equal to the function's formula and solve for the input. Solving can produce more than one solution because different input values can produce the same output value. Am I right? Okay, let us see evaluation of functions in algebraic forms first. When we have a function in formula form, it is usually a simple matter to evaluate the function. For example, consider this function f of x is equal to 5 minus 3x square. This can be evaluated by squaring the input value and multiplying it by 3 and then subtracting the product from 5. Am I right? So, when a formula is given for a function, we can evaluate by replacing the input value in the formula with the value provided and calculate the result. Okay, let me take one example and show you step by step. Here is an example. H of p is p square plus 2p. Now we are supposed to evaluate for h of 4. To evaluate h of 4, we substitute the value 4 for the input variable p in the given function. So, if I replace all p by 4, I'll get 4 square plus 2 times 4, 16 plus 8, which is equal to 24. So therefore, for an input of 4, we have an output of 24. Hope you are clear with this example. Here is the next example. A function is given, f of x is equal to x square plus 3x minus 4. In case, if you are given a number for this one, in the place of x, the input value is a number means we can just use algebra to simplify. In case, if we have a variable, just like a for example. If that is the case, the input value is a letter, so we cannot simplify the answer any further, just replace x by a. But in our example, we have to evaluate for f of a plus h. So this is an input value. We must use the distributive property here. So let me plug in that. Replace all x by a plus h. So here you have to use a plus b the whole square formula to express this, to expand this, and then use distributive property here, and then combine all the like terms if possible. You could have seen these types of examples in a previous video. Now let me post another evaluation part here. Here is an example. We are supposed to evaluate for f of a plus h minus f of a over h. So in this case, we apply the input values to the function more than once and then perform algebraic operations on the result. Okay. First, you have to replace all x by a plus h and replace all x by a, and then plug in these places and simplify by factoring out the h. Okay. Now let us see how to evaluate functions expressed in formulas. Some functions are defined by mathematical rules or procedures expressed in equation form. If it is possible to express the function output with a formula involving the output quantity, then we can define a function in algebraic form. Okay. For example, 2n plus 6p is equal to 12 expresses a functional relationship between n and p. So we can rewrite it to decide if p is a function of n. Okay. First, let me give you the steps. So when you're given a function in equation form, you have to write its algebraic formula. You have to solve the equation to isolate the output variable on one side of the equal sign with the other side as an expression that involves only the input variable. And you have to use all the usual algebraic methods for solving equations, such as adding, subtracting the same quantity, or you have to do the same operation on both the sides of the equation, multiplying, dividing both the sides of the equation by the same quantity, and then simplify your answer. So when you are given a formula form, it is easy for you to rewrite the given equation into the algebraic form and evaluate. Let me give you one example. Let me take this. Please consider this example. Express the relationship 2n plus 6p equal to 12 as a function p equal to f of n if possible. To express the relationship in this form, we need to be able to write the relationship where p is a function of n, which means writing it as P equal to expression involving n. So I'm going to rewrite. First, let me shift n to the right side of the equation. You have to do the opposite operation. Subtract 2n from both the sides of the equation. So we will get, our goal is to isolate P on the left side of the equation. So let's get rid of this 6. So divide the entire equation throughout by 6. So you will get, you can simplify it further. This is a common denominator for both the terms, so you can write it separately and then simplify it further. So you will get 2 minus 1 over 3 n. Therefore, p as a function of n is written as, hope you are clear with this example. It is important to note that not every relationship expressed by an equation can also be expressed as a function with a formula. Okay. Now let us see how to evaluate a function given in tabular form. We know that we can represent functions in tables. Conversely, we can use information in the tables to write functions, and we can evaluate functions using the tables. For example, how well do our pet recall the fond memories we share with them? There is an urban legend that a goldfish has a memory of 3 seconds, but this is just a myth. So let me take an example on the pet and their memory spans in hours. The function that relates the type of pet to the duration of its memory span is more easily visualized with the use of a table. Please have a glance over this table. At times, evaluating a function in table form may be more useful than using equations. Here, let us call the function p. I'm using this variable, p for pet. The domain of the function is the type of the pet, and range is the real number representing the number of hours the pet's memory span lasts. We can evaluate the function p at the input value of goldfish. So for goldfish, you can find that 2160. So notice that to evaluate the function in a table form, we identify the input value and its corresponding output value from the pertinent row of the table. So the tabular form for the function p seems ideally suited to this function, more so than writing it in a paragraph or function form. So when you are given a function represented by a table, you have to identify specific output and input values. For the given input in the row or a column of input values, you have to identify the corresponding output value paired with that input value. Find the given output values in a row or a column of the output values, noting every time that output value occurs or appears. Identify the input value corresponding to the given output value. So this is what we are going to do if you are asked to evaluate the questions in tabular form. Hope you got an idea about this. Here is another example. For example, if we want to evaluate for g of 3. Evaluating g of 3 means determining the output value of the function g for the input value of 3. The table output value corresponds n equal to 3 is 7. Am I right? So g of 3 is 7. Hope you are clear with this example. Okay, now next one is finding function values from a graph. Evaluating a function using a graph also requires finding the corresponding output value for a given input value. Only in this case, we find the output value by looking at the graph. Solving a function equation using a graph requires finding all instances of the given output value on the graph and observing the corresponding input values. Here is an example. So I have posted an example. A graph has been posted. Now let us see how to evaluate f of 2. So to evaluate f of 2, locate the point on the curve where x is equal to 2 and then read the y coordinate of that point. So the point has 2, 1. So f of 2 is 1. Am I right? You can also do the reverse. For example, if you get a question like this, solve f of x is equal to 4. So we find the output value 4 on the vertical axis and moving horizontally along with the line y equal to 4. So if you move, you get the corresponding value 3 here. Am I right? So these points represent the two solutions of f of x is equal to 4. And if you move left side, you'll get this point, negative 1. So when the input is negative 1 and 3, the output is 4. Hope you're clear with this example. So these are the four different types of evaluation. So you should know what is the input value and output value of a function clearly. In case if you have any query regarding this example and the topic, kindly let me know. See you in the next video. Have a great time.